Hey guys and welcome back. So today's video, like you can tell from the title, is obviously going to be an empties. I have my bag right here, which is filled with a lot of my beauty trash. Let's just put it that way. And I just want to quickly let you know that this is actually a pre-filmed video. I'm filming this video like more than 1 month in advance. So yeah, if the chronology of a lot of these products don't make sense to you, just know that it's pre-filmed, which is why. I try to get rid of this like as soon as I can, even though I like to collect my trash. So yeah, with that out there, let's just dive right in and get started and talk about all of this. But before that, I just want to quickly remind you that if you're not subscribed to my channel already, then please go ahead and click on the red subscribe button. That way you will get to see these videos on a frequent basis, and you will also get to see a lot of other videos from me that I keep doing, like product reviews, tag videos, a lot of stuff basically. So yeah, definitely make sure you subscribe and also hit on the bell button to get to know every single time I post a new video. I've been really regular with my Monday, Wednesday and Friday scheduled, touch wood, for a while now, thanks to the lockdown and thanks to the fact that we're at home since the past 4 months. But I've been stuck to this schedule for a while, and it's working really well. But it's just a good reminder to hit on the notification, because you might not always remember that, or if my schedule goes haywire, which it probably should not. Anyways, that intro was way too long. Let's finally dive right in. I'm just gonna pick up random things and not go in any particular order as such. Let's quickly start with a few things first that I'm not going to repurchase. I think that's enough for now. Actually, this one I'm going to repurchase probably. I mean, I don't need it right now because I have a lot of backups. This is the Avon Advanced Techniques Anti-Dandruff Keep Clear 2-in-1 Shampoo and Conditioner for All Hair Types. That was a super duper long name. So this is one that I like to keep on backup. I don't have a lot of moisturizing shampoos in my collection. This is the only one that I actually do like, and the one that really works well for me. If I feel like I don't have the time to like oil my hair and my hair is super duper dry and I don't want to like strip it further, I want to actually use something that is moisturizing, I tend to use this, because again, it's a shampoo and conditioner, so it's a more moisturizing shampoo. I use it like a shampoo, obviously. So yeah, I have a couple of backups of this, I believe maybe like 2 or 3, and I will obviously go through those first, and then I'm pretty sure I will continue repurchasing them, because I feel like this is the only moisturizing shampoo that really works well for my hair and doesn't weigh my hair down. I have a very oily scalp, so I feel like that's the reason my hair can tend to look a little flat and like chumpu, let's just say that, a lot of times. And I feel like this is the only one that works well for my hair. So yeah, not going to repurchase it right now because I have backups, but I will in the future. Moving on next. Now, the next couple of things I'm definitely not going to repurchase, all of them. So let's dive right and talk about them. The first one is the VLCC Alpine Mint and Tea Tree Gentle Refreshing Face Wash for Normal to Oily Skin. It is supposed to be soap free, but I actually can't tell. It only has the key ingredients mentioned. It doesn't have all of the ingredients, so I don't know if this has sulfates or not. It says it's soap free, but again, I don't know. Considering of how drying this was, I feel like sometimes even sulfate free cleansers are not that drying on my skin, but this one was definitely drying. And typically cleansers don't do that for me. Something like this is very, very rare. So that is majorly why I would not repurchase this. And even if it wasn't super drying, I feel like it wasn't like special enough for me. So personally, I would not recommend this unless and until you have like super duper 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 oily skin. Even if you have normal to like combination oily skin like I am, it's probably going to dry out your skin. And if you have like more normal to dry skin, definitely stay far, far, far away from this. So I'm not going to repurchase or recommend this one. So yeah, that was that. By the way, when I was using that, since I would like step out of the shower and my skin used to feel a little dry, I would use this toner. Yeah, this toner from Toli Moly. This is the Choke Green Tea Watery Skin. I don't know if I'm saying it right, but you can see I have used up the entire bottle. And again, I did like it. I remember also mentioning this in my Holy Grail products video, but I feel like that was like I called it a holy grail to soon, I feel like. So yeah, this one is unfortunately not a holy grail anymore. It's been dethroned, not by a different product actually, but I've just realized that you know, hydrating toners are just one of those, like, personally for me, unnecessary things. I know if you have dry skin you'll probably be offended by what I just said, but yeah, I feel like a hydrating toner is not really a necessary step. You should be using a good cleanser that is not over drying your skin and that is not you know, messing with the pH balance that your skin needs to have. And yeah, I'm just like, you know, I would rather spend my money that I'm spending on this toner on a different toner which probably has some sort of chemical exfoliation benefits to it. So yeah, I wouldn't repurchase it. Moving on, next, this one I've probably seen is disgusting looking tube. It looks literally disgusting right now. I don't know if the camera is picking it up. It's like yeah, anyways, okay, I'm sorry. This is the Plum Green Tea Daylight Sunscreen Gel SPF 35 PA Triple Plus. I did like the sunscreen, but then again, I feel like if I'm comparing how much I get with how much I get as in 50 ml of product for how much was this, 400, 500, I'm not sure. I feel like it's not as good of a value compared to like some of my other favorites, like the Lotus one, the VLCC one, and like so many other sunscreens. So that's the reason why I feel like I would not repurchase it. But I would recommend it if you're looking for a good sunscreen and if you want to support a brand that is doing a good job when it comes to like being environment friendly, because Plum, you can actually return your empties to them and they recycle them and they give you like rewards back for it and stuff like that. So you can check out their empties for, which basically means for good program, on their website. So yeah, I do like to support the brand and, you know, buy products from them whenever I can, but this is just not one of those, because I feel like even with those rewards, it's going to tend to end up being more expensive than a lot of others. So yeah, that's the only reason I won't repurchase this, but it was definitely a very good product. Moving on next to some okay, I was not expecting this to be, yeah, okay. Moving on next to the lactocalamine products, I have the lactocalamine oil balance face wash and I have the face scrub as well. Now these were things I was just like, okay, let me just buy them. They look good to me for some reason, and they were okay. I was not expecting them to be like really amazing, but I don't know, something about them made me want to buy it. And when I did, I wasn't disappointed in them, but it was just like, okay, you know, one of those things that you don't hate or dislike, but then it's just like, these did not blow my mind. They're not favorites. They were just okay to use. That's how I feel about these. Now, I'm not really a very big fan of the lactocalamine, like the actual cult favorite product, which I feel like everyone has used as a child. I feel like people still swear by it. Some of my friends still use it till date and absolutely love it. I tried out, I'm pretty sure, both the variants and I didn't like either. My mom actually likes calamine lotion as well, not lactocalamine in specific, but just in general. And I don't know why I'm rambling about all of these things, but these two are basically okay. Now, the face scrub I definitely wouldn't repurchase, because if you know me, I'm not a physical exfoliation person anymore. I do have a couple of face scrubs that I bought earlier, and even this one I bought before I made the switch, otherwise obviously I wouldn't buy it. But yeah, the ones that I have, I will try to use up in some sort of way. I obviously won't repurchase this. And this one, again, it was not a gel face wash, it was more of like a watery, creamy kind of a consistency. And for me to even use one of these, like to actually use this thing up, is a big achievement. So I will definitely say that the formulation is very nice. It's not a super creamy face wash that people with oily skin generally don't tend to like. So yeah, I will have to appreciate the product for that. But again, it did not blow my socks off. So yeah, that was that. Moving on next, we have the Aloe Veda Activated Charcoal Deep Pore Detox Face Wash. This one is also sulfate free and it's got activated charcoal, lemon peel oil, aloe vera. There's a lot of stuff. It's detoxifying, deep pore action, paraben free, soap free formula, etc. etc. You can tell I've used up the whole thing up, Now, the first major reason why I'm not going to repurchase, the main reason I'm not going to be repurchasing this is that I've made the switch from carbon cleansers and micellar waters to double cleansing and using some sort of a cleansing balm or a cleansing cream or anything like that. So I'm not going to be repurchasing any carbon cleanser in general. That's the reason I'm not going to repurchase. That's the main reason I'm not going to repurchase this. And even if I hadn't made the switch, this one I just tried for some sort of like, I bought this before I decided to make the switch. Just keep that in mind. A lot of things have been in my collection for a very long time and I have just not been consistent enough to use them up, which is why they're here. But this one I feel like was not my favorite kind of a carbon cleanser and it didn't do much for me. I like a carbon cleanser to not just cleanse my skin but also take the first layer of makeup off and take off like at least 65% or 70% of my makeup, and I feel like this didn't even take off like 50% of my makeup. So that's the reason I was a little bit disappointed. So if you are a makeup wearer and you're using a carbon cleanser, this is not going to do a good enough job. So keep that in mind. You will have to use some sort of other really heavy duty product. Or you can use it as a double cleanser, or like the second step of the double cleanse if you want to. So that is probably all of the reasons that I could give you as to why I'm not going to repurchase this. So yeah. Moving on, next we have the Khadi Natural Herbal Body Wash. This one is the lemongrass and orange variant. Now, first of all, I was super duper disappointed with the packaging. So when it came, this thing broke. Like, can you tell this? So I basically actually had to decant the whole product in a different bottle and use it up. And I have used it up. I liked it, but it wasn't really amazing or great. It came with 150? Okay, it came with 210 milliliters for rupees 150, so that was pretty inexpensive. That is a good thing, but then again, when it comes to me, I like to use get those really big value size body washes, like anything that has approximately anywhere between a minimum of 300 ml up, like 300, 400, 500 ml bottles. When it comes to body washes, I like to get those mainly because I feel like something like this would hardly last me for a month, but something like that would probably last for like 2-3 months. So in a year, I'm going to use up like maybe 3 or 4 of those, but this I will probably use like 10 or 12 of these. So yeah, when I use like a bigger size, I feel like I am creating less waste when it comes to like plastic waste and stuff like that. So that makes me feel a little bit better, and that's why I tend to go for like value size. So that is the main reason why I would not buy this, because I don't think this comes in a bigger size. Don't quote me on that, I'm not sure. And again, it was like an okay face wash. It did not smell absolutely amazing, because I know people don't like fragrance in a lot of products, but at least when it comes to body wash, I feel like, you know, it calms you or it wakes you up in the morning. Or, you know, having fragrance in a body wash, I personally really like. And also, I know a lot of people are sensitive to fragrance even in their body products. Like, it can tend to over-dry their skin, or it can cause acne, or, you know, a lot of things in general. But I personally don't have any of those issues, so I like a good smelling body wash. Just want to put it out there, because I feel like I've had a couple of debates with some people when it comes to fragrance. So just want to clear my stance on that. And again, I feel like I've been talking for a long time when it comes to that. Quickly moving on to another product, which is also body wash and which I have a sort of similar opinion on. So I feel like, okay, I should have had one more of this. I don't really know where it is, if I'm being sure. Okay, I cannot find it, but I do have one more of these. So I have a bigger size of this, which I bought with this from the supermarket, and it was a value pack or something like that. And then I bought this from Nykaa. I don't know which one I bought first and which one I bought after, but I ended up with duplicates of the same thing. And then this one I've used up, and this one I've used up. I again put it into a different container and I used these up. I don't know where the bigger size is. I think that one is still in my collection. That one I'm still like yet to use up. Because I cannot find it. I'm pretty sure I did use it up. Or I did not. Again, I'm not sure. You'll probably see it like in a future empties or something like that. So again, these were really, really good body washes. I do have to mention that. And I will say that if I can find the 500ml, which also has a pump, which when I checked on Nykaa was out of stock, and I feel like I've not seen it much online. So if I do see it online and I'm looking to buy a body wash, and you know, I'm placing an order anyways, I'll just add that in as well. But if I have to buy any of the smaller sizes like this one or the 200ml one, I believe that one is, then I wouldn't buy them. Again, for the same reason that I mentioned for this, the economical environment aspect. So yeah, that was for these. Then moving on, let's quickly talk about these two, which first of all I cannot repurchase because they are discontinued. I feel like a lot of people still don't know about it, and I've spoken to a few of you who were really shocked knowing that. I'm really sad because I bought them a really long time back. It took me a long time to like get into them. I wanted to do a full review on the whole range, and that did not end up happening because before I could do that, I was about to post it in end of May, and then somewhere in the beginning of May is when I found out that these are actually discontinued. So that kind of broke my heart, if I'm being honest, because I was like, I spent like what, 8,000 or 10,000 when I got my hands on the whole range. So yeah, by the way, if you're wondering, I'm talking about the Face Shop Chia Seed No Shine Intense Hydrating Cream and the No Shine Hydrating Cream. I have shared my reviews on these in my nighttime skincare routine. I'm gonna leave a link to that video in the description box. You can go ahead and check it out. But then again, is it of any use? I mean, you can't even get your hands on them anymore, so what's really the point? So I'm not gonna talk too much about it. I'm just gonna tell you that I've used up both. I mean, the packaging is white, you can't even see, but I've used both of them up completely. So yeah, we're gonna say bye bye to that. Okay, let me quickly talk about these two as well, because I feel like, again, I've spoken about them in the past. The Avon Clear Skin Pore and Shine Black Pore and Shine Control Black Mineral Mask with witch hazel and eucalyptus extract. This one I have like two or three backups of because I really, really, really like it, especially to deep, deep, deep clean my pores. So yeah, this one I'm not going to repurchase right now because I have backups. And once I'm done with those, we will see if I'm going to repurchase them or not. This one is the Avon, a new retroactive antioxidant purifying mask. This one, I feel like, is good for all skin types, which I really like about it. But I feel like for me personally, this is not the the best mask out there, because I feel like nowadays, if I am masking, I'm going to probably use something that can deep, deep, deep clean my pores. I'm not going to use something that is going to deep clean, but then is not cleansing enough. Like, I feel like this one, because it doesn't like really dry out my skin and draw everything out, I feel like I'm just like, you know, it's okay. It's good that it doesn't dry out my skin, but then it's not deep cleaning enough. Yeah, if you want to know more about these both, actually, for that matter, I'm going to leave a link to another video which I've done already, maybe like a month or two ago. So yeah, I talk about both of them along with three other products in that video. And my thoughts are still the same about them. Nothing has changed. So I feel like, yeah, I mean, this one is probably going to be like a future repurchase. This one is not. Let's just keep it simple like that. Okay, let's talk about these two last products and then we're going to end the video because we're nearing on 20 minutes here. I have the Plum Grapeseed and Sea Buckthorn Glow Restore Face Oils Blend. I started with not liking this product much, but then I realized that when my skin is a little bit more dry, like in the winter or even the summer when my skin is dry sometimes, I know that sounds really weird, but it just happened this year. So yeah, I'm not going to write off anything. Anything is possible, literally. So yeah, I feel like when my skin is dry, I like to use this in the nighttime, but I have other oils that I like more. So I'm not going to repurchase this one, but it is a good product. If you have normal to dry skin, you will definitely love this more than I do. So yeah, keep that in mind. I will recommend it if you have, again, normal to more dry skin, or if you have oily skin and your skin gets really dry every once in a while, seasonal changes. And then this one is the Makeup Revolution Quinoa Night Peel. This one I was hoping to actually love, but I didn't end up loving it much. I actually had to mix it in with my plum oil to kind of make sure that it works for me. So yeah, this product actually did not work that well for me. I would actually include it in like a disappointing products video or something like that, but I realized I don't regret spending my money on it because I could get use out of it somehow. But I wouldn't recommend it because when I say it did not work for me, I felt like it was, no matter how much I tried to like, you know, reduce the frequency or use it with different products, it just always caused some sort of burning, some sort of irritation. So then I was just like, you know what, let me mix it with an oil. It's going to, you know, make it a little bit more easy to use and my skin will be able to tolerate it. So that's how I made this to work for me. But then I wouldn't recommend, like, I don't think you should put that much of hard work into a product to like get it to work for you. There is so much better out there, but if you have to work so hard to make a product work for you, then it's just not worth it. So yeah, that was that. And yeah, that's it for all of these products. I'm gonna talk about the rest of the things in another empties video later on, so we're gonna have to save that, unfortunately, but I can't make this video any further longer. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope that you enjoyed. If I sound like you know, I'm on the verge of just breaking down and like fainting on the floor, it's because I've filmed so much today, literally, because I've been filming after so long that I'm just tired. I just want to go and sleep. That's how tired I am. So yeah, that was it. I'm also gonna leave an empties playlist in the description box, which I have on my channel. If you love watching more empties videos and you want to get to know about other products, you can check out a lot of my other empties videos as well. And yeah, that is it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I'm gonna go now. Bye. Bye bye.